Hi children, today I am going to continue the chemical properties of alkenes. In the last video we discussed about the addition reactions of alkenes. In this video I am planning to do first one, oxidation with KMnO4. KMnO4 is potassium permanganate. Next chemical reaction, ozonolysis, and third one, polymerization, and fourth one, reduction. Reduction, as you know, it is addition of hydrogen. Okay, each one we can discuss in detail today. First one, the oxidation with KMnO4. Alkenes, here I taken HCH2 double bond CH2. Oxidation means addition of oxygen. Yes, in presence of called dilute alkaline or neutral KMnO4. Called dilute alkaline or neutral KMnO4, in the presence of 273 Kelvin, we will get vicinal glycols. Vicinal means the OH group that it in the adjacent carbon atoms. That's why it is said to be the vicinal. Okay, vicinal glycols or diols. Diols means two OH group. Okay. All means OH. Yes, why this reaction? So this is the general reaction. Glycol, it is found. How is this product formed? So that we can explain. Here we taken called dilute KMnO4. So KMnO4, dilute means H2O. Due to the reaction, it results 2KOH plus 2MnO2 plus 3 oxygen. Yes, this oxygen and this alkene, in presence of aqueous solution, it forms ethylene glycol. How? This H2O. H2O in that HOH is there. One more O it is getting due to this reaction between this KMnO4 and H2O. Right? So this oxygen here we utilized now. So this O and H, here one more OH. So that will be joining here with the adjacent carbon atoms like this. Vicinal glycols or vicinal diols it forms. Its name is ethylene glycol or 1,2 ethane diol. So the OH group, the all groups, it is attached in the adjacent carbon here. Since during this reaction, two hydroxyl groups which is attached across this double bond. So that's why this reaction we can call in one more name, that is hydroxylation. So OH group it is attached here. So that's why it is said to be a hydroxylation reaction. Then this is also used for one test of unsaturation. One test, it's bromine water we discussed in the last video. The another test for finding out the unsaturation, that means double bond or triple bond, it's there with the help of this dilute KMnO4. So that test we are calling, the name is Bayer's test. Then what is that test? For explaining this Bayer's test, we need Bayer's reagent. Bayer's reagent means dilute alkaline KMnO4 solution. That is said to be the Bayer's reagent. So this Bayer's reagent, when we are adding to the double bonded compounds, here we used, you know. So when we add this KMnO4 into this double bonded or triple bonded compound, there is a decolorization of KMnO4. You know that the color of the KMnO4, it is pink, right? The pink color of that KMnO4 potassium permanganate, it is discharged. That means it is decolorized. That's why it is used for the test for unsaturation. Okay, so two unsaturation tests we discussed. First one, bromine water addition. The next one, KMnO4. Bromine water addition, it is an addition reaction. KMnO4, it is an oxidation reaction. Right? Both one, there is a decolorization of that. The bromine water, decolorization of the red color. And here, decolorization of the pink color it will be. So, these two are we are considering for the test for unsaturation. Yes, this bromine water addition with alkene that we discussed in the last video. The addition reactions video. So there is a two test for unsaturation: bromine water, addition in alkenes, or bromine in CCl4 also you can use it. Other next one, it is addition of bias reagent, that means dilute alkaline KMnFO solution to alkene or alkyne. One more example, we can use it for the addition of this alkaline KMnFO with the alkene, that it is CH3CH double bond CH2 plus, then H2O plus O we are adding, because you know that H2O and O you are getting from these reactions. Okay, that's why we are adding H2O and O here. So you will know that where will be the two OH group will be substituted around the double bonds. So CH3CH OH, one OH will be there, the OH it is comes from these two. So then another OH it will be there. So it is said to be the hydroxyl group. It is attached with the doubly across the doubly bonded carbon, and also it is said to be the hydroxylation reaction and forms vicinal glycols or vicinal diols. Okay, so its name is propane 1,2-diol. This is said to be the oxidation reaction because the oxygen addition it is happening here. Okay, so this is about the oxidation reaction when we are carrying with dilute KMnFO solution. When in alkene here you know that CH2 double bond CH2. When we are trying to heat with concentrated KMnFO, here also the oxidation reaction it will be happening. But when the oxidation occurs, here we used concentrated KMnFO. That's why here the cleavage of this double bond it will be occur. It results the formation of acids, ketones and carbon dioxide depending upon the nature of the alkanes. Now we can check how the formation of acids, carbon dioxide and ketone it will be forming here. According to the nature of the alkene, different products. Okay, so here we taken CH2 double bond CH2. So here the cleavage it will be there. So when the cleavage occurs, this part it is CH2. Then one more part it is there, that it is CH2. So two different way it will be existing. CH2 means HCH. Here also HCH. Here we are conducting the oxidation. So two of the oxygen it will be joining here. Two of the oxygen it will be joining here. So what will be formed here? It is formic acid. So two times HCOOH it is formed here. Okay, this is the formation of acid. Then you conduct again the oxidation reaction. It results carbon dioxide plus H2O. Two molecules of carbon dioxide and two molecules of H2, because here we took two molecules of HCOOH. So one more example we can do here, that it is CH3CH2CH double bond CH single bond CH3. So when you conduct concentrated KMnFO addition, trying to heat with 373 to 383 Kelvin, so trying to give heat, so this is 2-pentene. So can you imagine what all products it will be? Here also oxidation reaction it will be going on. So when this heating occurs, there is a cleavage occurring in the double bond. So two sets it will be CH3, CH2, CH, and you know that it is not possible to standing like this because carbon valence it's not satisfied. Okay, then CH, CH3. Here also you can see that there is no chance. Here oxidation we are conducting. So you know that two of the oxygen it is getting here and two of the oxygen getting here. So here what will be the change? You can see CH3, CH2, C. Two of the oxygen it will be joining here with them. And also this CH3, C. Two of the oxygen getting will be here. COOH. These are the mixture of two acids. It is formed due to this combination. Okay, with one more example I will do the same. Here butadiene you have to be right. CH3CH double bond CH single bond CH3. This is butadiene. See indeed. See, you are having to be added concentrated KMnFO. Right? trying to heat, so cleavage it will be happening like this. So the product formed here, CH3CH, and to the same parts now, so CH3CH, then oxidation means we are adding oxygen, so two of the oxygen will be getting substituted here, two of the oxygen getting substituted here. So these are the products, so that means two molecules of CH3COOH it will be formed here. This is ethanoic acid, so mixture of acid it is formed here, right? Here also clear, no? So according to the nature of the alkene, there is a chance to be conduct the oxidation again, you will get the carbon dioxide, but here you got ethanoic acid, ethyl acid only. So that will be depends on the nature of this alkene here we taken, okay? Next chemical reaction of alkene, it is ozonolysis. Ozonolysis of an alkene means it involves the addition of ozone, ozone it is O3, to an alkene to form an ozonide. Ozonide means how the ozonide it will be formed here, CH2, that means this double bond it is broken, right? Then this double bond completely change and forms three of the oxygen in between these two carbon atoms like this. Just remove this double bond completely and between this two carbon atoms we have to be arranged three oxygen molecule like this. This is said to be the ozonide. This ozonide it is unstable and it is an explosive compound. So this ozonide on reaction with zinc and water molecule, there is a cleavage of the ozonide, it will be happens. Cleavage in the sense like this. Cleavage of the ozonide, it will be happens. And it is changed to smaller molecules. Like here, when you write CH2O, this part what will be CH2O? But it is actually HC. HO, it is just split here. HCHO, that means two molecules of aldehyde, it is formed here. Right? So this is formaldehyde formation. So smaller molecules, it is formed because of ozonide's instability in the presence of zinc and water, depending on the structure of alkene. This reaction, it is highly useful in predicting, in detecting the position of the double bond in alkenes or other unsaturated compounds. So the formation of ozonide and its subsequent decomposition, that means due to the breakage you will get the product now. So that process together we are calling the name is ozonolysis. Different examples we have, we can do that. So next one, how the way the reaction between this propene and ozone it will be. So the ozone, when it reacts with an alkene, it forms ozonide. Ozonide, how it is formed here around the double bond. So I will write the product here. So CH3CH, then as we discussed early, the double bond you have to be removed and in between the double bond you have to be keep three of the oxygen molecules. Okay, like this. So here the product CH2, one of three of the oxygen molecule in the ozone you have to be keep like this and like to break. So what's the next step? This also oxygen, no, it is not utilized. So two oxygen only utilized for this chemical reaction. So the product formed here, CH3CHO, this part you have to be together, you have to be right here, and this part together you have to be right here. So CH3CHO plus CH2O. CH3CHO means acetaldehyde, okay? Then CH2O means HCHO. This is the same as that of HCHO. So acetaldehyde and formaldehyde is the product of this reaction. So ethanol, methanol is the IUPAC names. So in the presence of zinc and H2 only this reaction, ozonide it will be splitting. Okay. Then one more chemical reaction I will write here, that it is CH3CH double bond CH3CH3. Okay. So when you are conducting the ozone in presence of zinc and H2O, what will be the reaction product? It is very simple. Around the double bond you have to be arranged three oxygen and just make the cleavage. So what will be CH3 CH, then this double bond you have to be change it and keep the three oxygen molecule around this, okay, like this. So I am not doing the, I will do in the here oxygen, see here, here, okay. Then this carbon, no, it is having already 2 CH3, so you have to be arranged 2 CH3 like this. Then try to break as we did early. So what will be CH3 CHO, this part together and this part together. So what's that part? Plus CH3 CO CH3. So what's the product you have formed? You can see CH3 CO CH3 means this is ketone and this is acetaldehyde, that means ethanol. One more example we can discuss now, that it is write 2-methylpropene. What is meant by 2-methylpropene? CH3 C CH3 double bond CH2 plus ozone in presence of zinc and H2O. So what's the reaction product? Around the double bond, three of the oxygen molecule in the ozone arrange and forms ozonide. Ozonide, it is unstable, that's why in the presence of zinc and H2O there is a cleavage again occurs and forms the different products. So here CH3 C CH3, it's the, so for our reason as we can just CH3 CH3 like this you have to be do, and CH2. So the oxygen forms here, okay, here, then try to cleave like this. So what's the product? This part together and this part together. So CH3 CO CH3, then CH2O. CH2O means you know that it is HCHO. So different products it is formed, ketone and propanone and formaldehyde. Formaldehyde it is formed here. Okay, methanol. Next one, polymerization reaction. You are very familiar with the polythene bags and polythene sheets. Polythene is obtained by the combination of large number of ethene molecules at high temperature, high pressure and in the presence of a catalyst. The large number of molecules thus obtained, it is said to be the polymers, and the process it is said to be the polymerization. So the polymerization, it is the process in which larger number of simple molecules, simple molecules means N means larger number of simple molecules, here we taken it is ethene, okay, simple molecules combine to form the bigger molecules of high molecular mass. How it is formed? So I will write here CH2 double bond CH2. I will take two or three numbers, okay, not N number it is possible, so three numbers here I taken. Yes, so what, how the way the bigger molecule it is formed, this bond it is shifting here and make a bond between this, make a connection between these two carbon atoms, and this bond it is shifting here and this bond it is shifting here, likewise it will be continuing, right? So what's the product? It will be CH2 single bond CH2, because this bond it is shifting there, no? So single bond again, so CH2 single bond CH2, this bond it is shifting there, single bond CH2 single bond CH2, likewise it will be continuing. So that is why we written it as N. So the product here for this formation of this combination of this the large number of simple molecules, it forms CH2 single bond CH2, then we can write like this N times, likewise the molecule it will be formation, it will be continuing. So the small molecules of this one combines together to form the bigger molecules, it is said to be the polymerization, and also the small molecules we can call the name is monomers, and the bigger molecules here formed, you know, that one's name it is polymers or macromolecules. Monomers, macromolecules or polymers. The alkene which can undergo this polymerization reaction in the presence of suitable catalyst. So here we used 473 Kelvin 673 Kelvin. In between this, the here we are using the catalyst. It is traces of oxygen. Okay. So here, catalyst in the presence of that only the polymerization process it will be occur. So here we are heating the alkene at a particular temperature and under pressure. In the presence of traces of oxygen, it polymerizes to form this compound. It is said to be polyethene or polyethylene. Because why it is said to be poly, many, mono, one, that is the meaning. So monomer changed to polymer, so its name is ethylene or ethene. So when it is changed, its name is polyethene or polyethylene. Okay, then n number may be 100 or 1000 in between. This polyethene, no, polyethylene, it is used for making toys, bottles, electrical insulators, laboratory articles like funnel, measuring cylinder, etc. Now we can do another polymerization reaction with the propene. So N times CH3 CH double bond CH2, we have to be take it under heat, high pressure, and in the presence of catalyst when you are contacting. How will be the double bond? That places only the change. So we can write like this: CH3 CH double bond CH2 plus N times. N times here I am writing only very few number, and maybe 1000 or 100 in between approximately. Then again one more, I am writing only 3 number here. So how will be the bond? It is shifting here, the bond it is shifting here, the bond it is shifting here. So what the product? CH CH3 CH2 single bond. Here bond formation, then CH single bond CH2, the bond it is formed here between these, bond shifted there, no, so there is a connection between these two will be happen. So likewise it will be continuing. So that's why we are written like this. So how many number we taken on the base of that? N molecules polymer it is formed. So monomer here we taken, it is propene, it is changed to the polymer. Polymer I will write here CH single bond CH2, then CH3 have to be keep it the same, and you can write like this. Okay, this is the polymer formed here. Its name is polypropylene. Polypropylene. So mainly this reaction is going on in the presence of the catalyst peroxides. So generally when we are discussing this polymers, it is used for manufacturing of plastic bags, squeeze bottles, refrigerator dishes, toys, pipes, radio and TV cabinets, etc. Polypropylene here formed, you know, propylene. Okay, propylene here we prepared, it is used for the manufacturing of milk crates, plastic buckets and other molded articles. These materials all it is common, you know that, but excessive use of this polyethylene, polyethylene or polypropylene is a matter of great concern for all of us. Okay, next chemical reaction, it is reduction, it is addition of hydrogen. This reduction reaction is applicable both in the double bond or triple bonded compounds, that means alkenes and alkynes. So when we taken the alkene here, in that addition of hydrogen, no, reduction. So when we conduct the reduction in the presence of nickel and try to give the heat, so what will be the, we discussed in the Marconi Coffs addition, the addition of dihydrogen, the same situation here also. So one of the H goes to here and one of the H comes here, and double bond it is changed to 2 sigma bonds. Okay, so you will get the corresponding alkanes. So this reaction we can conduct in the presence of finely divided nickel, platinum or palladium. When the reaction is going on, you will get the alkane. Yes, this is said to be one more name, catalytic hydrogenation. Why it is said to be hydrogenation? Hydrogenation means, you know, that hydrogen addition. Hydrogenation means hydrogen addition in the presence of catalyst. That's why catalytic hydrogenation the name. Yes, it is very important reaction and it is very applicable in the next year organic chemistry classes and all. Next thing, it is having one of the important use. This it is used for the manufacturing of vanaspati from vegetable oils. Vanaspati from vegetable oils, for that manufacture this reaction it is very useful. Okay.